Hi friends, welcome to Learn and Explore. In the previous video, that is part 1, I had imported some points from an Excel file to AutoCAD, and in the part 2, I had imported the text for that points. Now I will import the lines to join the points and features to make a topographical map. So I will discuss this topic in this video. If you think this is very useful for you, then subscribe our channel to get more free tutorials. So this is my data sheet, and from where I have imported the text and points in my previous two videos. So these are my points are here, and I will make a topographical map from this data set. Now I will connect the road points. So for that I will create a layer named as road. Then I will create a layer. Yes, so I'm giving the name as road. Yeah, I'm setting the color as blue. Okay, and it has active layer now. Close. So in normally if you think that my points has been imported, and if you do that work to taking the polyline command, p line command, and connecting each points by manually, it is very tedious work, you know. So but I will not do this. I will do this by only from the Excel, just using some formulas and copying it and paste into AutoCAD. The line will be drawn automatically. Just see the methods I will use. I will connect these lines, the road right side. So I'm going to the data sheet. Now I had already created that format string common ordering by using concatenate formula. You can go to the previous video by going to the description where I had given the link. So now I'm searching for the road RHS code so that I can join the lines, the roads. So here it is, the road RHS points are here. So just I'm copying the string common ordering formats and just copying it and going to AutoCAD, and now using the PL command, PL for shortcut, and polyline PLINE. It is the command for polyline. So I'm using the command p line, and then now right click and paste. See, the lines has been drawn automatically. This is very simple, and very it will save your time, and it is totally accurately measured. So if I want to connect the road left side points, so I'm copying the road left side points, going to AutoCAD, and again I'm using the p line command, right click on the command bar and paste. So the left side of the road is being copied, and for center road, copying it, AutoCAD, same p line command and right click, paste. Now see here the point is not closed. You can enter CLOAC to close the polyline, or only just C enter. Yes, that's it. So I have created the road, and now I will do something. I will join lines for another point codes. So now I'm taking the BD wall 1. So I'm searching for BD wall 1. I'm creating a layer for that boundary wall. Boundary lines. B being the color. In the color is blue and okay. Giving the line line type as fencing, loading the line type, okay, selecting the line type and okay. Now set as active layer. Now close. So I have set the layer for boundary walls, and also I had set the boundary point type. Now I am searching for BD wall 1. Otherwise you can filter this text. It also takes a lot of time to find the code. Just if you filter the data, I'm showing you, I'm selecting the row, the overhead row, going to data, going to home menu, and here it will find filter. Yes, so filter is also very important. Going to searching for BD wall 1 here, click OK. So this points only for boundary wall 1. So I'm copying it and going to AutoCAD, same PL enter, right click on the command bar and paste. See, the boundary lines has been imported. Now I will go for boundary wall 2, same copy and paste to AutoCAD. Again for the same boundary wall 3, the last one, copying into AutoCAD and paste. See the time, it will not take so much time if you know the formula. Just copy and paste, you have to do it. Another code is the fence, layer is same, paste. Another one code, any boundary was there, PF wall 1 and PF wall 2. PF wall 1 is a parapet wall, platform wall, railway platform wall. Same command, yes. Now wait a minute, I'm drawing the platform wall 2 also. Here it is, copy. It's a very simple method, you just follow the steps and you can do this easily with your own data. Please comment in the comment box to for any suggestion for us, or whatever your doubt is, I will tell you. Now I will connect the railway lines. Here I had the points. I am creating a layer for the railway line. Going to layer menu and railway track. Okay. I'm giving the color as a red. Yes. Okay. And loading the line type. It should be track. Up to your choice, whatever line type you can want. I'm giving a track. So okay, now setting as active layer and close. Don't forget to set as an active layer. So now see, these are the railway lines, as you can see. Now I will connect the points. First I'm taking railway LHS. So I'm copying this text, using command ordering format, and PL enter, right click in the command prompt and paste. See, the railway lines has been imported, and same for the railway right side. I'm copying it into AutoCAD and paste it to the command bar. Yes. Now, so I had imported the lines. Now I will tell you how to import a specific symbol for the features, or a block you want to copy the block in each point. Suppose for that you have the data of electric post, okay, or you have data of heart, lot of data, but you want to paste a single block to each and every datas, each and every points. For this, what you have to do is the filter menu and selecting that electric post, electric transmission lines, arts, lever room, etc. Pond, there are 3 ponds are there. So I'm selecting all these. So cement slab, this is just a building. So PL command and paste it, and C for close, C enter for close. So this is how we can do a building. And dustbin to show the map, show in the map, same. PL enter, paste, C enter for close. I had hearts, so I want to create a heart here. Just creating the heart. Just normally I'm creating it now. You can also bring your own symbol if you already have. Just to make you understand, I'm just simply creating this heart. Just wait a minute. That's it. Trimming the lines. Yeah, my heart is created. It's not quite good, I know, but I will work with this. So to create a block, go to block, block enter, or B enter simply, and specify the base point, and give, you should give a name for the block. I'm giving the name as hut, HUT hut. Now okay, so this is single hut. Now if you want that this symbol, this block, you want to paste in each and every points, so what you will do? If you do it manually, it will take a lot of time. I will do it by Excel. So what I'm doing is CP enter, specify the base point, that is now in that option. I am going to Excel and going for the heart coordinates. These are all the coordinates. Just copy it and go to the AutoCAD and right click, only right click and paste. See, all the hearts has been imported in the respective points. Can see here also some hearts, that the points has been imported. One more time I am showing you, I'm taking the example, nala. Yeah, I'm drawing the nala. PL enter and right click paste. I'll show you the block again, just wait a minute. I'm doing the ponds. You can also do the do this like this. Suppose if you had the list of data, so first you enter PL, after that the string command ordering, and then again when you shift to the another code, you have to give two rows there, blank two rows, and you have to copy this manner: PL, then string command ordering, then one space, then again PL, then this. You have to copy to the last. So if you PL enter and paste it, and if you like this, don't, you don't need to enter any command. Here I am closing this. If you want to join the lines, then you can also use p edit command. What is p edit command? I will tell you later. Now I'm creating an electric post here. Yeah, this is electric post. and I want the same CP command, CP baseband. I'm going to Excel and searching for electric post. Just copy all the and right click paste. So the electric post will be copied in each point. Now I'll show you. I'm giving the example of block again. I'm making a tree right now. I'm making a tree. See, just for example, just to show you, I'm just doing it. If you have the symbol, then it will be, it will come very fine. It will be so. Tree. I'm making the tree. These are the tree leaves. So guys, wait, now I will create a block using the B enter. B, if you type B enter, then also we will create a block. I'm giving the name as tree, PK base point here. Okay, so I have chosen the base point here. So now I'm moving it to here. Now same CP enter, switch by the base point, going to Excel. And choose the tree points. Tree points. Oh, how is that? Okay, I'm going to filter menu. I have to choose tree. Okay. Now I will find it. Yeah, here it is. So I'm copying the points. And then right click and paste. So all the trees has been imported again. Can see it is what you have the symbol that is imported to the points. Now the rest of the part you have to do it manually, or you can do it sometimes the data may be missing, so do it manually. For example, here it is, the 3 points has been taken, 1 point missing. You can do it like this. Okay, so this is how you can do a topographical map. And this is, I'm giving the name SC enter to scale the scale any drawing or any object. I have used this. The scale command is very important for any survey engineer or civil engineer, for any engineering drawing, scale command is very important tool. I will make a video and give you a tutorial using the scale command in the next video. So now my drawing is ready. I had imported first the points, and then I had imported the text for each points, and in the text there was code and the labels were there. I had imported this, so I had discussed it in the part 2, and now in this video I had discussed the how to import the features and the lines using p line command and the block command and the cp command. So I hope you enjoyed this, and it will surely help you. If you think this video is really helpful for you, please do me a favor, subscribe our channel and keep supporting us. So thank you guys for watching these videos, and keep supporting. Please subscribe our channel.